This is one of the coolest insect predator-prey interactions I've ever filmed. Let me introduce you to this, a rove beetle in the genus Stenus. And the thing it's about to attack is this, a tiny springtail in the genus Falsomia. Watch what it does. Stenus beetles have a projectile mouthpart that works kind of like a sticky harpoon, and they shoot it at their prey. Here, let me show you what that footage looks like again. It happens fast. This sequence you're seeing was filmed at 6,000 frames per second. After the prey is caught, the beetle retracts its mouthpart and begins its feeding process. One thing that makes that footage interesting is how small and fast everything is. This little square of sand is where that beetle lived while it was here in the lab and where I filmed those sequences. Here, let me show you what it looks like in real time. First, a couple misses. Here are both those shots going frame by frame. In both of these, the mouthpart goes from retracted to fully extended in just a single frame. And here, in real time, are two successful prey captures. The attack of the Stenus beetles has to be fast because their prey have one of the fastest known animal escape jumps. This is them. This is one of our springtail colonies, and you can see how fast they are when I move the substrate and they scatter away by jumping. Here's what that escape jump looks like in slow motion. They have a spring-loaded appendage folded underneath their bodies that they use to fling themselves several body lengths into the air and away from danger. I've actually been researching springtail jumps here in the lab for years, and there are several other videos in this channel that are all about that. The Stenus beetles are able to catch them because they don't need to touch their prey before they strike. With their huge eyes, they visually orient themselves and can strike from a distance. This one shoots its harpoon into a crevice in the sand and successfully pulls out a springtail. It's able to do that even while the springtail is moving and bumping into the sand because their mouthpart ends in a pair of ultra-sticky pads. The stickiness comes from both microstructures at the ends of the pads and an adhesive secretion that they're coated in. Other insects that have fast-moving mouthparts to catch springtails, like trapjaw ants, have to get closer and even touch the springtails before they attack. This can give the springtail time to sense the predator and jump away. With a Stenus attack, it's likely the springtail has no idea what's coming and no time to react. Now there are a bunch of other cool things to know about these beetles. One amazing thing is that there are over 3,000 described species within the genus Stenus, which means there are more species of beetles like this than there are all praying mantises. If you want to go on a search for one yourself and experience this kind of satisfaction when you see one, you might search in places like this, around the edges of streams and amongst the rocks. And if you're lucky, you might also see them doing their other special trick of skimming across the surface of the water. I haven't seen this yet, but it's on my list. So, with any luck, I'll find more of those beetles, and there'll be more videos about them here on this channel. But for now, thanks for watching.